In today's video, I will show you the best and easiest way to create realistic water reflections in Affinity Photo. What's up, y'all? I am IAMRENSI, a surreal digital artist from the Netherlands, bringing you the best tips, tricks, and tutorials that will help you turn your imagination into reality in Affinity Photo. And today we've decided to change things up a little bit. You might already notice it from the background and from the quality of the camera, but last week I've decided to help some bigger brands who prefer to stay anonymously. And in return, they've decided to support my channel, of course, for which I'm super grateful, and of course, which allows me to invest it in the channel, upping the production value of my videos. Now, with that being said, of course, you're here to learn something. So let's just dive right into Affinity Photo and let me show you how we can create the most realistic water reflections in Affinity Photo. Let's go. All right, so we've jumped into Affinity Photo and I want to show you how to create realistic water reflections. So I found this image on unsplash.com and of course, this is a perfect image to recreate some water reflections because right on this picture, we've got a model and you can actually see like a realistic example of the water reflection or how the water reflection would look like in this image in real. So let me zoom out and let me go to my assets and drag one of my animals in, which is this penguin in this case. So let's resize it a little bit. So I hold command to resize it from the center. And I will right click and transform and flip it horizontally so that it's actually like looking the other way around or the other direction. Now I'm gonna put it like somewhere around here because I wanted to make it look like the girl is looking at the penguin. So let's drag the penguin or place it right around here. And now we go to our layers panel. And as you can see, the penguin is like the temperature of the penguin, let's say, so the color is a little bit too warm. So what I want to do is adjust the color first before I do anything else. And we're going to do that by creating a white balance layer. So let's go to our adjustment layers and let's click a white balance. And right over here, this window will pop up. And we can use the top slider to actually cool down the color of our penguin or the tone of our penguin. So let's click this one and drag it to the left. So now you can see that the whole image is affected and that is because we didn't clip it to the penguin. So let's drag our white balance layer below our penguin and let's clip it to the penguin so that it only affects the penguin layer. All right, so let's find a good temperature for the penguin. And I would say that would be right around here. So this looks good to me. So let's cross this off and let's zoom in a little bit. Now I want to transform the penguin a little bit. So I will just move this one tiny bit to the left so that it actually looks like the penguin is standing more straight. And there's one more thing that I want to do before we start creating the reflection. And that is actually mask some stuff out right over here. So you can see this toe looks kind of funny. So let's create a layer mask and let's press B to select the brush. And with a soft round brush, we simply brush out some parts of the feet so that it actually blends a little better with the water. And I think this is about fine. So let's hit command 0 to zoom out. And alright, so I think this penguin looks good like it is. So let's right click it and let's rasterize it so that it becomes one layer. So that one will get rid of the mask. So we'll actually apply the mask and we'll apply the adjustment layer, the white balance adjustment layer. So let's click rasterize for now and let's double click it and rename this penguin. Alright, so what we want to do now is we want to create a reflection of the penguin. And obviously, right over here, we've got our real-time example. So let's first press Command J to make a duplicate. And the top one is going to be the original penguin, let's say. And then our bottom penguin is going to be the reflection. So let's select the second penguin layer, let's say. And let's call it reflection. And we want to flip it vertically. So we right-click the penguin. we go to transform and we click flip vertical. So now we move it down. So I hold shift while doing this so that it actually stays in the same vertical line. So I hold shift and I drag it down till right about, let's say about here. So let's zoom in if this looks good. So actually it does look pretty well. And you can see that the reflection of the girl is pretty dark. Or is it a girl actually? I'm not even sure, but I assume that it's a girl. So you can see that the reflection of the girl is pretty dark. So what I want to do, we could of course check our blend modes. So we could check our darken blend modes, and well, the multiply blend mode looks kind of good. The linear burn also looks kind of good, but it gets too dark. So I think we'll just stick to normal. And let's add a levels adjustment layer so we can actually tweak the color of our reflection a little bit. So let's clip it to the reflection. And now let's drag our output white level to the left so that it actually becomes darker, as you can see right now. And you can see that the face of the penguin gets too dark. So this is actually way darker than the reflection or the original reflection in the image. So this is not possible in real. So let's drag our output black level also up so that it actually starts to match the other reflection, let's say. So this looks about fine to me. So let's hit command zero again. And now we've actually gotten this pretty cool overlay of this penguin already. So let's cross the levels adjustment layer out now. And I think it's time to get some of this texture. So if we zoom in on her reflection, you can see that we've got this really nice texture of the water. So it actually looks like this is a reflection. And of course, our penguin layer is way too smooth still. So let's fix this. So let's press command zero. And let's select our reflection pixel layer. So what we want to do now, and this is an amazing trick. I'm sure that not many of you actually know this or actually have done this before. So pay good attention, and this is going to help you a lot when creating realistic water reflections. So what we want to do now is we want to go up to filters and we want to go to distort. And in the distort filter menu, we want to find displace. So let's click on displace and this window will pop up. So there's some checkbox that is says scale to fit. So we'll come back to that later. So let's keep it checked for now. And there's two buttons. So actually there's four, of course, there's cancel and apply as well, but there's load map from file. And then there's the option to load map from layers beneath. Now, of course, our layers beneath is the background. So that is actually our background layer, which is this one right over here. So let's click on that one, load map from layers beneath. And what we want to do now is, like, if we zoom in, you can see that our penguin already has a little bit texture of the layer below, actually. So let's zoom out. And once we drag this, slide it to the right and we release, you can actually see that the penguin starts to get some texture off the layers beneath, but it looks kind of weird and it doesn't really, like, the preview doesn't really work well, as you can see. So when I zoom in, it looks really, really distorted, let's say. But when I zoom out, it kind of like gets back to normal. It is kind of weird. So what I found is that like around 80% would work in this case. So let me press command zero for now. And let's hit apply. So once I hit apply, you can actually see that our penguin or our reflection layer actually has gotten this amazing water texture. So now it actually looks like the penguin is actually being reflected here in the water, just like the reflection of the girl. And well, maybe in our case, it is a little bit too strong. So let me press Command Z to undo that. And let's go to filter again. So let's go to distort. Let's go to displace. And maybe not do it 80 this time, but maybe let's stick to 65 maybe or something. So let's zoom out. And let's hit apply again. So let's see what happens. And somehow nothing happened. So let's do that again. So let's go to filters. Let's go to distort. Let's go to displace. I forgot to click load map from layers beneath. And let's now go to 66 or something. And let's hit apply. So now the distortion is a little bit less than just a moment ago. It might be still a little bit too much, but let's just keep it like it is in this case. So let's press Command 0, and you can see that we've got this really, really amazing reflection texture, and we've actually got it from the layer below. So instead of using a separate displacement map or whatever, we can actually simply use the displacement map from the layer below. All right, so now there's one thing that I want to do to make this a little more realistic, and that is actually, like, I think the penguin and the reflection, like, at the bottom right here is too realistic, or I'm not really even sure how to explain it, but I think it is too clear and too nice and too smooth. So let's go into our reflection layer and let's press the mask icon. So let's select the mask for now. And let's grab our brush tool and increase the brush size by using the right bracket key. We can zoom out a little bit, and I want to simply click once. So maybe around here, and maybe click once right around here so that it's just a little more fake. So this was the before. And this is the after. So in my opinion, this just looks a little better to me. Now, the penguin might be still too colorful, maybe. So we can try to add or to decrease the saturation. So let's go to the HSL adjustment layer. And over here, we can decrease the saturation a little bit. And we can also decrease the lightness. So this way, we actually match it better with the original reflection in this image, which is the reflection of this woman. So by sliding the luminosity shift in the HSL layer down, it actually looks more like the actual real selection, the real reflection. So let's not do it too much, because this girl has some really dark colored clothing, so a dark pants, a dark jacket as well, and the penguin is pretty bright, so let's not go too dark on this one. But I think like this, it would look pretty cool to me. So let's zoom out and let's cross this off. And well, the penguin is maybe a little bit too colorful for me still, so let's go actually to the original penguin layer, and let's go to a vibrance layer. Let's clip it to the penguin. And let's just decrease the vibrance a little bit so that it matches a little better with the rest of the image. So this is the before, and it's pretty hard to see. And this is the after. So this is tiny adjustment. So maybe we can even decrease the saturation a little bit more. Just like so. All right. And that's how to create an amazing, realistic water reflection by using the displacement filter. All right, guys, and that was it for today. As you might have noticed, the content of this video, I recorded in the middle of the night, so I was a little bit more quiet, but I will be sure that in the next video, I will have as much energy as I do have now. So once again, thanks to the brands who supported my channel and supported me as a content creator. It was very exciting for me to record my first video with the setup that you can see right now. And of course, you will see much more from me with this kind of video quality. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. At least I had a lot of fun in showing you how to create water reflections. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy my content overall, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Alright, that being said, if you want to learn more about photo manipulation, just check out the next videos that I will put up for you in the screen. So these will be more creative videos, and well, of course, I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Ciao.